titi aye oba 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 titi aye
To the Lord, a beautiful song. I will praise His name, for the Lord is good. Hallelujah.
Sing unto the Lord a joyful
song.
I will praise His name, for the Lord is good.
Hallelujah.
Sing unto the Lord a joyful song. I will praise His name, for the Lord is good.
I will sing unto the Lord a beautiful song. I will praise His name, for the Lord is good. I will sing unto the Lord a joyful song. I will praise His name, for the Lord is good. Hallelujah.
Sing unto the Lord a joyful song. I will praise His name, for the Lord is good.
Oh, hallelujah.
Sing unto the Lord a joyful song. I will praise His name, for the Lord.
Oh, hallelujah.
Sing unto the Lord a joyful song.
Oh, hallelujah.
I will praise His name, for the Lord is good.
Are you sure you praise Him this morning?
Yes!
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you cannot dance, just do it anyhow. Body understand. Now look at me. I want you to put your hands on your head. If you know you have a good head, you can't be bad head. Your head not good head. Anywhere you go to, doors go they open for you.
Thank you. be the name of the Lord. Now, are you seeing the presence of God? This is the new grace God has given to this ministry. Wave your hand and bless the name of the Lord. Just wave your hand and bless his holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody shout, I am under the influence of the Spirit of God. I am under the influence of the Holy Spirit. I am no longer an ordinary person. I have been taken over by the Spirit of God. I manifest the grace of God. I manifest the power of God. Whatever I do from now, I prosper. In Jesus' name. Shall be seated. Let's pick our Bible to the book of Haggai, chapter 2. Don't forget, we have been dwelling on your prayer life. That the theme of this month, your prayer life. We are going to the book of Haggai chapter 2. After Zephaniah, you get to Haggai. After Habakkuk, you get to Zephaniah. If you want to get Haggai as well, you can go to Matthew. Then from Matthew, begin to go back. You will meet Malachi. Mm-hmm. Then after Malachi, you meet Zechariah. Then after Zechariah, you land Haggai. Haggai chapter 2, verse 9. Haggai 2, 9. I take it from here. It says, the glory of this latter house shall be greater than of the former, saith the Lord of hosts. And in this place will I give peace, saith the Lord of hosts. The glory of this latter house shall be greater than the former, says the Lord of hosts. And in this place will I give peace, says the Lord of hosts. Holy Spirit of God, reveal yourself to the scripture. Through me to my hearers today and to me in Jesus' name. People of God, meditate on this. The Holy Spirit is the glory of the church. The Holy Spirit is the glory of the church. B, without the presence of the Holy Spirit, prayers are in vain. Without the presence of the Holy Spirit, prayers are in vain. Prayers becomes noise. Prayers becomes entertainment. Prayers becomes lebuki, becomes hard work without the Holy Spirit. Prayer becomes very, very hard. So without the Holy Spirit, prayers are in vain. V or C, don't defy yourself. It will prevent the Holy Spirit from your life. Don't defy yourself with sin. When you do this, it will prevent the Holy Spirit from your life. Then, imagine the kind of life you will live as a Christian when you are defied with sin. When the Holy Spirit is no longer in you, how will you talk to God? You are already stained. God will no longer be interested. That is why every child of God, be very careful. Don't defile yourself. If you defile yourself with sin, it will prevent the Holy Spirit from your life. D. Be cautious of the Spirit of God. Be cautious of the Spirit of God always. Because many Christians have not been able to train themselves on godly meditation, to meditate always on the Word of God, that is why negative thoughts have taken over. You now begin to retrain yourself again in meditation on the Word of God. This will give room, opportunity to the Holy Spirit to take over your mind. You now be conscious of the Holy Spirit of God. When you are conscious of the Holy Spirit of God, you will experience the fullness of God's presence. The Holy Spirit is the glory of your life. The Holy Spirit is the glory of the church. And the Holy Spirit is the glory of your house. Whatever you do for a living as a Christian, if the Holy Spirit is not involved, the glory cannot shine. Even in your business, you can't experience glory manifestation because the Holy Spirit is not there. You can't be a good Christian without the Holy Spirit inspiring you, guiding you, and instructing you. So the Holy Spirit, you must be cautious of the Holy Spirit. When you are conscious of the Holy Spirit, then you are careful of what you do. As Christians conscious of the Holy Spirit, you don't just jump into any action, into anything. If you want to do or make any mistake because you are conscious of the Holy Spirit, He will tell you, this you are about to do will defile you. It will disconnect you from God, from your fellowship with God. This thing will hurt you. It will hurt your spiritual life. You are just yourself. You are a Christian. Whenever you want to commit sin or do anything, you don't hear any voice at all that tells you, hey, this you are about to do will separate you from God's fellowship in the spirit. You don't hear that voice. You don't have that in your conscience. Oh, you need to restart again. You are not yet in fellowship with the Holy Spirit. When you are in fellowship with the Holy Spirit, you will say, the Holy Spirit will guide you always. He becomes your monitor. He becomes your prefect, guiding you against that which would have destroyed you or your relationship with God's fellowship. So every Christian must be cautious of the Holy Spirit. Galatians chapter 4, verse 6. I told you last Sunday during my message, watch and pray. I gave you that scripture, Galatians chapter 4, verse 6. The scripture says, because ye are sons, God have sent the Spirit of His Son into your heart. Yes, because ye are sons, God have sent the Spirit of His Son, Jesus Christ, into your heart, crying, Abba, Father. That means, in your heart every day, the Spirit of God is supposed to be there. Once it takes its place in your heart, you will be conscious about the things of God. Most time, when we think about our business, think about our family problem and on and on and on, it doesn't really even attract success. It is God that gives success. When you are conscious of the Holy Spirit, He gives you instruction about your business. That same thing you have been doing for years that refuse to produce better results for you. Because you receive a divine instruction now of who you are conscious about, you will succeed. Peter, when he was fishing, he fished all through the night using his wisdom. Their glory was not there. He couldn't catch single fish all through the night until he came in contact with the Spirit of Jesus. That seems to be what we are talking about now. And Jesus said to Peter, stretch forth thy net. As he complained, he said, Master, I have been here throughout last night. I have been fishing using all my wisdom. He said, Master, you know I am a professional in fishing, but I don't know what is happening. If I throw my net, it's only dirty. It will go and pack all the dirty inside the river. Bring dirty out. Naughty good. Follow my net out. I don't know The enemies are worrying me. They trouble me too much. I can't pay my children's school fees. My house rent. He began to count all his problems. Jesus said, you don't need that. Jesus said, partner with my spirit by borrowing me your boat to minister. And he ministered. And Jesus said, now, you have submitted to me now. You have partnered with me now. You have partnered with the Holy Spirit in me now. And I will prove to you that the Holy Spirit can change your story. He said, Peter, lay down the net. And he stretched the net. Peter dragged the net. The net dragged Peter. He dragged the net. He nearly fell inside the sea. Bible says Peter began to call, beckon on his friends, come and help me. When they dragged the net out, the net was getting torn because of the overload. The biggest fishes inside the ocean located the net of Peter. Why? Peter was no longer conscious now of the things of life. He was not conscious about Jesus Christ. And Jesus blessed him. No, God have sent the spirit of his son into your heart, bearing witness with your spirit, crying, Abba Father. Every true child of God needs the Holy Spirit. Without the Holy Spirit, we are wasting time in the church. Without the Holy Spirit, I am wasting time as a pastor. Without the Holy Spirit, you are wasting time as a Christian. That is why everyone needs to yearn and thirst for the Holy Spirit, because he is the solution giver. He is the one that will glue you to God. Somebody shout hallelujah. Always remind yourself that you have received the spirit of adoption. You remember? Always remind yourself that you are what? Can you talk to me, please? Always remind yourself you have received the spirit of adoption. Say to yourself, I have received the spirit of adoption. Can you say it again? I have received the spirit of adoption. Romans chapter 8, verse 15. I gave you the scripture last Sunday during the message. Watch and pray. Romans 8, 15 says, for ye have not received the spirit of fear to fall back into bondage, but ye have received the spirit of what? Adoption. Ye have received the spirit of adoption. No, I'm going somewhere. Pastor Makwe. Yes, ye have received the spirit of adoption. Now, as children of God, always remind yourself who you are. Until you remind yourself who God has made you to be, who you are in God, you can't enjoy the spiritual grace. Until you know who you are, remind yourself who you are, you can't enjoy the spiritual grace. I have been adopted by the Holy Spirit. When I know that I have been adopted by the Holy Spirit, when I want to pray for you, I don't think about how you will be healed. Because now, I have been adopted. The Holy Spirit is part of me. Two, God, because I am a son, God has sent his spirit, the spirit of his son, Jesus Christ, into my heart. So, if I pray for you, I'm not the one praying for you. That spirit is the one praying for you. How God is going to prosper you, I pray for you for prosperity. I am not the one praying for you. It is that spirit he has given to me that is in me that is praying for you. You are believing God for fruit of the womb. You have cried so much. Oh God, now I am telling you, don't worry, I am seeing a baby boy by you. It is not P.I.O. Basaki telling you that I am seeing a baby boy by you when you have cried for a baby for more than 21 years. No baby coming forth. It is that spirit that have adopted me. That spirit of Jesus that God have given to me is the one speaking through me to you. And that is why you must believe. Jesus says, if thou wouldest believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. But when you take the words for granted, the spirit has spoken to you. You say, oh, pastor say, daddy say, that's why you are missing it, because we are too familiar. John 6:63, Jesus says, the words I speak unto you, they are what? Spirit, and they are life. That is, if you want to be somebody and be better under this spiritual grace, you must believe the word of the Spirit. You must recognize that you are not an ordinary person. You have been adopted into the kingdom, adopted by the Holy Spirit. So, it is the Holy Spirit that lives in you now. It is no longer you that live it, but Christ that lives in you. Somebody shout hallelujah. Many Christians easily forget themselves. You often see yourself as ordinary. You compare yourself to the unbelievers. When you sit in the midst of the unbelievers, you talk the way they talk. You do the way they do, because you don't know who you are. You don't know what God has given to you that is inside you. Until you know what God has given to you that is inside you, it will not work. Until you know what God has given to you that is inside you, it won't work for you. Until you know what God has given to you that is inside you, it won't work for you. Say I hear. So many Christians are looking for magic. Magic. Magic miracle. Does it work that way? God is not magical. You must follow the reality of the word of God. Until you follow it, there is no way you get godly attention. Now, that brings me into the topic of today's message, the Holy Spirit and you. The Holy Spirit and you. The Holy Spirit and you. If you lack the Holy Spirit, you will malfunction. No matter who you are in the house of God, you can be a pastor in the altar. You can be an elder in the church. You can be what? A bishop. You can be a prophet. You can be a deacon. You can be an evangelist. You can be an apostle. When you lack the Holy Spirit, you are empty. You are a storyteller. You can't prove God. That is why when many that lack the Holy Spirit, when they see the grace that God has given to us in manifestation. For example, someone is prophesying to now, and evil spirit worrying the person. You call the person, you stretch your hand, pray for the person. You see the person vibrating, shout, cry, scream out. That is the Holy Spirit at work. It is not P.I. or Basaki doing that. It is the spirit that was adopted inside him. The same spirit is in you, but you don't recognize him. But those that didn't recognize this spirit, they will criticize and say, this is not ordinary. You don't have to be an ordinary person, because once you have been adopted by the Holy Spirit, you are no longer ordinary. Somebody shout, I am not an ordinary person. If you know who you are as a child of God, your language will change. If you know who you are as a child of God, your language will change. Two, you will never be afraid. You hear the scripture in Romans 8:15. For ye have not received the spirit of fear to fall back into what? Bondage. But ye have received the spirit of what? Adoption. You carry the Bible every day. Do you know what is in it? Have you gotten revelation? No matter where you are walking, listen, no matter where you are walking, never you see every other person there who does not know the same God you know. Don't see them as the same with you. They may dress better than you. They may occupy position higher than your own. Listen, in the things of the Spirit, you are greater. Somebody shout hallelujah. Until you are greater in the Spirit, you can't really experience the desired breakthrough in the physical, because it is the spiritual that controls the physical. You may be rejected now. You may be abandoned now. You may be neglected now. You may be cajoled now. You may be criticized now. But the time is coming. The Holy Spirit will introduce you. Somebody shout hallelujah. Many a time they will mock you. But one single manifestation the Holy Spirit will do through you, they will regard you. We are talking about the Holy Spirit and you. Somebody shout, Lord, I need the Holy Spirit. Before you do anything, even when one is offending you, listen to the Holy Spirit. You guide yourself always not to offend the Holy Spirit, because it's a precious gift from God to your life. Somebody shout hallelujah. I'll give you a few points. Where we read in the scripture, Haggai 2, verse 9, it said, you saw it just now. It said, the glory of this latter house shall be greater than of the former, said the Lord of hosts. And in this place will I give peace, said the Lord of hosts. What is the glory of the latter house? The Holy Spirit is the glory. When we are talking about church, what is the glory of the church? Is it the building? Is it the beauty? Is it the chairs you have here? Somebody come here and say, if you see the chairs in that altar, they put white chairs in that altar. This, that. They put glass table on the altar. They put this very beautiful, this, that, this. Is that the glory of the house? That is not, these are empty. The real glory of the latter house is the Holy Spirit that is present. When the choristers were ministering just now, you saw the glory in manifestation. The glory beam from here illuminated you. You began to behave like one who doesn't know what he's doing in dancing. I saw a brother coming in as he was walking in upstairs. He was dancing like a mumu. Yes, the glory has illuminated him. That is the cloud of glory. When you are under the influence of the glory, you are taken over by the spirit of adoption that has influenced you, that has dominated you, makes you to behave. As he will, to the glory of God. Yes, the glory of the latter house is the Holy Spirit of God that illuminates the people of God in the house of God. Now let's go to the scripture more. When you discover Acts chapter 2, verse 1 to 4, Acts of the Apostles. Acts of the Apostles. Let's open down there. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, verse 1. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind. And it filled all the house where they were what? Sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of a fire, and it sat upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterances. Like I said just now, they were in the house. When the Holy Ghost came upon them, they began to behave like people who are idiots. They behave against their will. They behave out of normal senses. Why? They were full of the glory of the Spirit of God. And the Spirit of God gave them utterances. When the Holy Spirit comes on you, he gives you utterances, that's why you speak in tongues. Because he has adopted you, he influences you, he speaks his language through you. And this is the heavenly language. This is what every child of God needs. Although there are counterfeits of this, but you need the original of it. The apostles, they received the original of the Holy Ghost baptism, and that's what produced godly results in their ministry. You don't receive the Holy Ghost and speak in empty tongues. When you speak in tongues, one, you feel the presence of God. When you speak in tongues, two, the church will be full of God's presence. One speak in tongue here, it will hit the other one there. The other one speak, it will hit the other one there. The other one speak, it will hit one there. It will spread around. Why? Because it is of God. Somebody shout hallelujah. This is what you are about to experience now. This is what is about to come on you now. This is what is about to illuminate your life now. This is what is about to change your spiritual life now. This is what is about to come on your spirit right now. Somebody shout hallelujah. This is the Spirit of God that the church needs. Today, the place called church has become empty because the Spirit of God is not there anymore. All we see are entertainment. No, nothing like that here. Every one of you, you are going to receive the touch of the Holy Spirit today. You will manifest under His influence. You will go with this Spirit, function in this Spirit, and you become a new person from now. Somebody shout hallelujah. Briefly, I give you some 3 points. First, the Holy Spirit is a cloud of glory. 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 10 to 11. 1 Kings, let's go to 1 Kings. 1 Kings 8, 10 to 11. The Holy Spirit is a cloud of glory. 1 Kings 8, 10 to 11. I take it from here. And it came to pass when the priests were come out of the holy place that the cloud filled the house of the Lord, so that the priests could not stand to minister because of the cloud. For the glory of the Lord had what? Filled the house of the Lord. The glory of the Lord had filled the house of the Lord. The Spirit, the Holy Spirit, is a cloud of glory. You see, that even in the days of the kings, the kings could not start to minister in the house of God, because their glory was strong. People of God, we need this glory back. Somebody shout, we need this glory back. We need this glory back. When this glory comes, this way you come to the house of God, you are baptized by this glory. When you go, you become a manifesto. When you go, you become success. When you go, you become breakthrough. When you go, you become the sons and daughters of God wherever you are. When you go, people begin to see what is happening to you. They want to be like you. Somebody shout, that is my desire. I am not hearing you. Somebody shout, that is my desire. The glory filled the house, that even the king, they could not start to minister because the atmosphere were charged up of the presence of the Holy Spirit. And everyone were influenced. And that's why whenever you are coming to the house of God, prepare to meet with the Lord. Don't prepare for entertainment. Your mind should agree with the Spirit of God. That is when you encounter Him. You hunger and thirst for Him. That is when you encounter Him. He is always ready for those who are ready for Him, because He is already present in the house. Somebody shout, I know. See the encounter in 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 10 to 11. Verse 11, it said, the priest could not stand to minister because of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord had filled the house. You also remember when the people of Israel were coming from Egypt. The Bible said the cloud of glory followed them. The Holy Spirit was a cloud of glory that followed them to protect them. If this has been right from time, that means you need Him. You need a cloud of glory to follow you. Contact this in the house of God. Be conscious of it. Go with it. It will manifest in your life. It will manifest in your business. It will manifest in your marriage. It will manifest in your profession, in your academy, in whatever you do for a living. It will manifest and it will introduce you. Although we are in the world, we are not of this world. So you need the power that is not of this world to back you up, to protect you, to defend you, and to bless you. Because you live in a world where people are using charm to do business and all of that. So you that is a Christian, you can't use charm to do business. What you need is what is greater than charm. That is the Holy Spirit. Somebody shout, I need the Holy Spirit. Shout it better, I need the Holy Spirit. Somebody shout it better, I need the Holy Spirit. The house of God was full of the cloud of glory that a priest could not stand enough to minister. The glory was much, was stronger, influencing everyone that was present. No wonder the Bible says the glory of the little house shall be greater than the one we are reading in the Bible now. the glory you are going to experience here shall be greater than the one we are reading now. Somebody shout, I believe that. We are talking about God. He is not a man of God. He is a God of man. So I will tell you. Point number two. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. 1 Corinthians 6. Lift your eye there. Your body is the temple of what? 1 Corinthians chapter 6. Now you have seen the glory fill the house. Now, what about you? It is your body the Holy Ghost occupies. The Holy Spirit occupies your body. The cloud of glory occupies your body. Now, how do you now prepare your body to receive him, to retain him? 1 Corinthians chapter 6. Are you there? 1 Corinthians 6 verse 19. I take it from here. 6:19 to 20. I take it, say, what? Know ye not that your body is a temple of what? The Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own. For ye are bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. Glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. Your body, your spirit, they belong to God. They must be submitted to God for God to influence. Now you can see. And that's why I said to you earlier that you must be conscious of the Holy Spirit. I said to you earlier, you must be conscious of the Holy Spirit. You must become a Christian that meditates on the word of God, that will attract the Holy Spirit to your life. You must become one that don't joke with sin. Don't defile yourself. Don't defile your spirit. You go ahead committing the sin of fornication, you are defiling your spirit. You go ahead taking alcohol, you are defiling your spirit. You go ahead committing adultery, you are defiling your spirit. You go ahead smoking, you are defiling your spirit. You go ahead committing all sort of nuisance, you are defiling your spirit. The Holy Spirit can't reside in you. You may be in church now, as you are here, hearing me right now. Your past sins are forgiven. The Holy Spirit will locate you, possess you. You will live here with a package of the Holy Spirit this morning. But if you not go back again to those sins again, the Holy Spirit will not leave you and come back to me. He will leave you and come back to me. The rest will sit down here. Because he is ready for those who are ready for him. Those who are ready for him should be ready to live a sacrificial life. Your body, your spirit, they are for God. That's what the Bible says. And you know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. So, how do you handle your body? Forsake sin. You will be able to maintain the Holy Spirit. Point number three. The apostles prayed under the influence. They prayed under the influence. Acts chapter 4, verse 24. Acts 4:24. They prayed. The apostles did not do anything without the Holy Spirit. That was why they manifested in their days. Today we are reading about how God used the apostles. It wasn't on their own. Jesus Christ did not even release them without the Holy Spirit. Jesus asked them to go to the upper room. You saw it just in Acts chapter 2, where they were baptized with the Holy Spirit. The cloud of glory came upon them, and they went with it, and they were ignited by the fire of the Holy Spirit. They went and did exploit. You can do same as well. Somebody shout, I believe. Acts chapter 4, verse 24. I take it from here. Acts 4:24-31 says, I'll just take only 31. Acts 4:31, please, because of time. Acts 4, verse 31. 31 says, and when they had prayed, and the place was shaken, where they were assembled together, and they were all what? Filled with the what? Holy Ghost. And they spake the word of God with what? Boldness. When they prayed, the place was shaken. It was the Holy Spirit that made the place to be shaken while they were praying. Power, there were power in operation. Demons ran for their dear life. Forces of darkness ran for their dear life. Where the apostles were praying, they were praying under the influence of the Holy Spirit. That is why I said to you, without the Holy Spirit, prayers are in vain. The Holy Spirit is the strength of your prayers. The Holy Spirit is the one that prays through you. You have that song last week or last 2 weeks. Spirit, pray what? Through me. The Holy Spirit is the one. And that is why you need the Holy Spirit. You don't want to live a vain life. You don't want to live a frustrated life. You don't want to meet heaven on the last day. You don't want to be an abandoned project in the hand of God. You need the Holy Spirit. You need the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit and you is what we are talking about. You neglect the Holy Spirit, you are living a counterfeit life. Without the Holy Spirit in you, you are living a dangerous life. With the Holy Spirit in you, you are stronger than whatever that may fail, because the Holy Spirit becomes your strength. Shout with us to our faith. Come, Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit is what every child of God desire. Open your heart to Him right now. I've said to you, your sins are forgiven.
Lord, we worship you.
Flow along with these songs right now. Open your heart to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit and you.
Come. Amen. Oh, come and dwell in this place. Come and dwell in this place. Come, oh, come and dwell in this place. Come and dwell in this place. Holy Spirit, come,
come.
Oh, Spirit will say, come and dwell, come and dwell.
In this place.
Oh, Spirit, come.
Come
and dwell. And dwell.
In this place.
Oh, Holy Spirit, come. Precious Spirit will lead you. Oh, come on, the Spirit.
Come and dwell.
Come and dwell.
In this place.
Yes, your Spirit, come.
Come
and dwell.
And dwell.
In this place, in this place.
In this
oh, say, Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come. Oh, come, oh, come, oh, Spirit, come.
Come and dwell.
Come and dwell.
In this place.
Oh, Spirit, come.
Come.
Oh, oh.
And dwell. In this place.
Come. Oh. Place. Oh,
Right now, ask the Holy Spirit to come dwell in your heart. Lift up your voice wherever you are. Ask the Holy Spirit to come dwell in your heart. Holy Spirit, come dwell in my heart. Dwell in my heart, Holy Spirit of God. Dwell in my heart.
Holy Spirit, come.
Ask the Holy Spirit to dwell in your heart.
Holy Spirit, come. Father, we're in you. Father, we're in you. We're in you.
Come.
Holy Spirit, come.
And dwell.
Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come. Oh, precious Spirit, go. In this place, in this place. Righteous Spirit, come. Come, come and dwell. Holy, holy, holy,
holy, holy.
Come and glow.
As the Holy Ghost will dwell in your heart, wherever you are. As the Holy Spirit will dwell in your heart, to dwell in your heart. I need the Holy Ghost in my heart to help me to pray.
Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, come, come. Come and dwell
in
our hearts. Holy Spirit, come and
dwell.
And dwell, and dwell
in our hearts.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Wherever you are, just lift up your voice right now. Ask the Holy Spirit to come and dwell in your heart. Holy Spirit, dwell in this place. Holy Spirit, dwell in our midst. Holy Spirit, dwell in our heart. Open your mouth and talk to the Holy Ghost right now. Wherever you are, give yourself to the Holy Ghost. Ask the Holy Spirit to dwell in your heart. Dwell in this place. Dwell in our midst. Invite the Holy Spirit to take over you. The glory of this latter house shall be greater than the former. The glory of this little house shall be greater than the former. In Jesus' name we pray. Everyone say this after me. Oh, Holy Spirit of God, I open my heart to you. Dwell in my heart. Come dwell in my heart. Take your place in my heart. Take your place in my spirit. Influence me with your power. Influence me by your power. Help me to remain under your influence. Oh, Holy Spirit of God, dwell in our midst. Oh, Holy Spirit of God, dwell in our midst. Oh, Holy Spirit of God, dwell in this place. Fill the house with the cloud of your glory. Oh, Holy Spirit of God, let me never remain the same. Help me to pray from today. Help me to hear you from today. Help me to know you from today. Help me to walk in your ways from today. Help me to overcome sin from today. Help me to acknowledge you from today. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You are blessed. A clap of it to Jesus Christ. Now, the Holy Spirit is already residing in you. You are going to maintain his office in your heart. Coming Sunday, get set, for Holy Ghost baptism. Yes, coming Sunday, get said, prepare your heart now. Begin to meditate on him every day, every minute of the day. Then coming Sunday, you are bursting into a new realm. You are bursting into a new realm. This is the Holy Spirit and you. Somebody shout hallelujah. Shall be seated.
Shout hallelujah. Shall we put our hands together for Jesus? Tell a neighbor I'm blessed. Are you blessed? You are blessed forever in Jesus' name. Yes, you are here. You have testimony you want to share with the people. Before we take our general offering, we want to listen to this announcement. I want you to begin to package your general offering as we listen to this few announcements. Our church workers. Our family deliverance is actually July 16th to 18th. So let those who have not registered their family meet the secretary at the close of the service. Please, as church members, we need Jesus. Shall we please rise up now? Lift up the offering before the Lord. The word of God says, give and it shall be given. As you give to the Lord will reward you handsomely in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for giving seed for us to sow. Lord, receive our offerings.
You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
In Jesus' name, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Shall I be seated? Can I see your newsletters? Your newsletter, quick, bring it, raise it up. I have a wonderful treasure. If you don't have, get for yourself now. Before I get to you, beginning from here, the gift of God without man. Oh, we travel together. I have a wonderful
treasure, gift of God without measure. Oh, we travel to me.
Thank you. Sit down. If you have not got newsletter, begin to get now. I'm coming.
In the name of Jesus Christ, every attack on this baby is destroyed. Mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Spread your mouth. So you are going to give birth to your child safely, eh? Congratulations. God bless you.
Thank you, Jesus. I'm free. Me and my baby is free.
As Christians and as children of God, whenever we find ourselves in difficult situation where we feel we can no longer help ourselves, our first port of call should be Jesus Christ, because he said in his word in the book of Matthew 11 verse 28, which says, "Come unto me, all ye who have labored and are heavy laden, for I will give you rest." And that was the case of Mrs. Ruth Osaige, who came to the prayer line session of Divine Grace of Glory Church with the issue of overdue pregnancy. According to her, she said the doctor's reports gave that her baby was not well positioned. And by God's grace, she met with the God of Pastor Piyi Obaseki at the Mountain of Mercy, where God's mercy and grace spoke for her. And today she has a testimony to share. Let's meet Mrs. Ruth Osaige and listen to her wonderful testimony and experience. More Grace viewers, thanks for staying connected to More Grace TV. Right now we are with Mrs. Ruth Osaige to listen to her experience. More Grace, ma.
From glory to glory.
Tell us your name and name of the person sitting beside you.
I'm Ruth Osegi, and the woman sitting beside me, she's my mother-in-law.
Can you tell us the problem that brought you to the prayer line session of Divine Grace of Glory Church?
Yes, the problem that brought me to the prayer line session is overdue pregnancy.
Like, how many months was your pregnancy?
10 months.
So when you came to the prayer line session, what happened? What was your experience at the prayer line?
The man of God, Senior Pastor Pierre Obaseki, prayed for me and used the balm of Gilead on me.
So immediately after you went through the prayer line session, what happened?
After then, before I came to the prayer line session, they told me that my baby head was turning up. That is the most problem that brought me to the prayer line. After then, when the man of God prayed for me, the baby turned and I delivered successfully.
So you mean to tell us that immediately after you went through the prayer line session, your delivery was as that of the Hebrew women?
Yes.
We thank God and we rejoice with you for what God has done for you. So what's the sex of your child?
Girl.
Okay, ma. Thank you. God bless you, ma. Now let's hear from her mother-in-law what she has to say. More grace, ma.
Glory to glory. I thank God. Say my daughter-in-law was delivered safely. Thank God. I give glory to God.
Ma, this is the gift of the balm of Gilead similitude. We are instructed by God's servant, Pastor Pierre Obaseki, to give you this gift of the balm of Gilead similitude. So, ma, what do you have to say to Pastor Pierre Obaseki for this gift?
Yeah, I want to tell my papa, Senior Pastor Pierre, thank you very much. May God bless you.
God bless you too, ma.
That's a wonderful one. We bless the name of the Lord. You need protection. Thank you. Okay, God bless you. You, not them.
Basiki, prophesize.
You see snake talking to you just like a human being, with the voice of a human being.
P-I-A of Basiki, prophesize.
You see snake talking to you just like a human being, with the voice of a human being, talking to you in a dream. Eh?
I'm the one, sir.
What is your experience?
The devil beat me on my hand since February. I can't sleep at night.
Who beat you on your hand?
The snake.
So what did the snake tell you?
The snake told me, all this while, I'll be escaping. I'll be running and hiding under the shelter of prayer. That other people serve them, that I refuse to bow before them. I only proclaim the name of the God I'm calling. So he left that day. The following night, I heard a bite here. I was feeling maybe I slept over the hand. I was hearing the voice laughing, deep, strong laugh. When I woke up, the hand was everywhere. Then I went to my shop. I couldn't sell. I came back home. Since February till now, the thing was like elephanty, very big. Very big. The thing is moving. I was complaining to my husband. Since February, I've been sleeping on the floor. I dare not sleep on the bed because when it started, I see my hand is inside fire.
So the snake come to you in your dream?
Yes.
To talk to you?
Yes.
Like a human being?
Yes.
The snake said, what? You are hiding under what?
I'm hiding under prayer.
Under prayer?
Yes.
That others worship him?
Yes.
Did you phone me to tell me about this, your experience?
No, Daddy, the truth is this. I've never met you, neither watch you on your television. There was a day I was waiting. I was lamenting, God, my husband has spent all. We have empty.
You have spent money?
Oh, even my children, we hardly eat. They are at home, no school. We have spent all we have.
Spend it for what?
For treatment. They will tell me, go here, 50,000, 30. Some we even collect it. So the other one collect my phone the other day, all the name of treating me.
Collect your phone, your handset from you.
Yes.
Because there was no money again.
There was no money, Papa. So at the end of the day, I was betting, I was lamenting. I said, I could have gone to Lagos to see our father in the Lord if I can get the anointing. That is Prophet TB Joshua, if I can get the anointing water. Then I heard the voice in my bedroom when I was betting. He speak to me. I was hearing the voice of Papa, Prophet TB Joshua. I said, with our language, I have a servant in this place. Why can't you go? I said, I have tried all.
Oh.
Wait. What is your language?
I'm a Yoruba.
Okay.
So he spoke.
Say it in your language. Say it as I told you.
Onya, omo mi, mama sukumo. Mama ni woli si bi bai tele ro lo ba. Onya o ti o baba, won won ti gbowo mi je. Won ti gba phone mi ta ni mo le pe. Oni sha pe customer kan. O lo wa si bi bai. Oni wasun na ni bi bai. Sha pe o ma fun ni phone number ton ma fi wa bi bai. Oni to ko buru ma pe. Then I was still betting. When I came out, I don't have phone.
Okay, now interpret that Yoruba in English now.
Then when I was betting, I was weeping. Then I heard the voice of Papa saying.
The voice of who? Mention the name.
The voice of Senior Prophet TB Joshua. I said, I have a servant in this land. Why are you crying and worrying, thinking you don't have transport to come to Lagos and receive your deliverance? Go to my servant. He will do what I ask him to do. I said, what? They have deceived me. They have collected all I have. My business money is gone. We are empty in our home.
Did you hear? They have deceived her. They have collected all she has. Her business money is gone. Go ahead.
He said, no, there is a woman that attends the church. She's a customer. Call her. I said, I don't have phone. He said, your mom will come. Really, my mom come that morning. I said, mommy, give me your phone. Then I searched for the paper where I wrote the numbers. I called the woman. She's an Igbo woman. I said, do you know so-so man? He said, yes.
Which man?
Do you know there? And I said, there is a so-so man. I said, he answered the name of our governor, Obaseki. I said, but that is what Papa told me, but I don't know. He said, but that is the name of our pastor. I said, so is even your pastor, and you have come and visit me every day on top of the bed when I'm sick. You can't even tell me you have a man like this. Then I just kept the anger. I just swallowed it. I said, give me the address. He gave me the place. He came to pick me at Ewa Road Junction. She brought me to the church that last week, Wednesday. When I left, I went inside my room. I kneeled down and said, Lord, you connect me to this man. For you me to know that you are still alive and you answer prayers. There is a true man of God that exists. You did not connect me through any man. You connect me through your own servant again. Father, I will not come here long. My tears shall must be wiped away. So I called my husband. When my husband came, I gave him this thing I collected last week, Sunday, the prayer.
The newsletter.
And I had to explain to him. He said, is there such man in this land? I said, yes. He said, this time around, you will send me and give to the pastor. Since we don't have money again.
He said,
I will sell him and give the money to the pastor then.
The other said, will not sell him and give me the money.
Yes.
Since he thought I am one of those that charge you money. Okay, go ahead.
He said, Tom, go and let's see what God can do. I said, no, God has started. I said, I saw Senior Prophet TB Joshua. He was talking to me. And I believe he that sent me there is with me. And he will set me free.
Now, the man of God, my mentor, Senior Prophet TB Joshua, recommended me to her in a dream. What else are you talking about? I said, the danger of unbelief. If you don't believe, you are the one that will be suffering. Just believe, so that the grace will work for you. Somebody shout, I will believe. I don't know this woman. This is my first time of seeing her. I don't know what she's going through, but this is how God works. She sat down on her own gently, and the Spirit of God gave me the message. You are just there. That looks strange. You are there. Snake is talking to you like a human being in the dream. And this is here today. You have heard all the explanation. Now, what is next? Is for her to be delivered and be free with this power of God that is in me. Have you heard prophets, witch doctors, false pastors have emptied them, collected all their money? When money finish, one told her, use your phone to pay. Somebody who is crying with two eyes. Are those the servant of God? Somebody crying with two eyes. No money again. Again, I be. You tell us if you don't get money, bring your phone. You say, bring your phone. Use your phone to pay. Now, their business wreck. Their children cannot go to school. To feed, problem. Why? The havoc that false ministers of the gospel have done to them. Now, that is enough to discourage people from going to church. So many people are at home today, they say, I'm not going to church again. Because of waiting and not see for church, I know they go again. I know they go again. You can't tell them about church again, no. They say, I bet they go. You know them? Bring them, come here. Wherever you are, God is bigger than your problem. Remember that song this morning we sang? God is bigger than what people say. Freely have you received, and freely shall you give. Thank you. So, madam, this is your last cry.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
So, now, what do you want God to do for you now?
I want God to fight for me and heal me. I'm sick. And heal me from this affliction. And restore all we have lost in my home.
You want God to heal you?
Yes, Papa.
Deliver you?
Yes, Papa.
Now, I restore all that you have lost.
Amen.
In your home.
Amen.
Sir, do you believe God can deliver her?
I believe God will deliver her.
Now, you didn't hear the story. She had a very strong voice laughing in a dream. The snake had been boasting. And they attack her in her hand. Since when?
Since first week of February. First Monday of February.
The hand has been a problem. So how does the hand disturb you now?
I dare not sleep on the phone.
On the phone?
I dare not.
Sleep on the phone?
Because the hand is always hot. So I need to sleep on the floor for the floor to be cool in the hand.
If you lie down on the phone for like 5 minutes.
If I see the hand, the heaviness. I need to call my daughter to drag me up because lying down like this, I can't carry the hand anymore. Or when I lie on the floor will be cold entering the hand because the thing is so hot that I cannot
even. So as we are here now, how does it disturb you now?
The thing is moving. I feel it. Sometimes to run to this place, it will bite me. If I see the very first day the snake beat me, to run back again.
You can't sleep on the floor and enjoy it now. Your body will be paining you.
I'm even having back pain.
Eh?
Back pain.
What is causing the back pain?
Because of the floor I'm sleeping.
The end has come.
Amen.
Thank you. Stand here. Thank you, Father, for glorifying your Son, Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name.
The man of God stretched forth his hands to pray for her in the name of Jesus Christ.
Ow!
As the power from on high hits her, taking her out of oppression from tissue.
Ow! 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 In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, out of her!
To flesh. From bone to bone, she is healed.
That is what a collected hand said for. That's what they collected all their money for. They collected all their money, collect answers from. So this is the day the Lord has made. We rejoice and be glad in it. It's a new beginning for her from today. If millions of this generation will believe the gospel we preach, they must see proof that Jesus is Lord. Thank you. Madam, come. Stand. Check your hand. Thank you, Holy Father, for glorifying your Son, Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name. Is the pain still there now?
Are the saints arriving on? It's you that I see. It's you that I see. Are the saints arriving on? It's you that I see. It's you that I see.
Jesus, all glory be to Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name.
To the glory of God, the man of God, on behalf of the Morgan City Department, hands over cash gift of 20,000 naira to the glory of God.
After receiving divine healing,
glory.
My name is Mrs. Bose Peter. I'm originally from Ondo State, but based in Benin here. I'm here to return all glory to the God Almighty of this commission, who has set me free from pain and untimely death, who has made my children not to become a motherless, who has made my husband not to become a widower. I give him all the glory. It all started in the month of February.
Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. Grace be unto you in Jesus' name. So at the end, she was delivered. Her hand began to function. She could carry her baby now. She came for her testimony. Everyone watching this testimony, today you are receiving your testimony. Rise to your feet right now. Rise to your feet until this prayer point. Jehovah my God. Can you take it better? Jehovah my God. Every wicked power fighting my testimony, I end your chapter in my life. Open your mouth and pray right now. Open your mouth and pray. Every wicked power fighting my testimony, I end your chapter in my life. I end your chapter in my life. Every wicked power fighting my testimonies, I end your chapter in my life. End your chapter in your life right now. End your chapters in your life. End your chapters in your marriage. End your chapters in your family. End your chapters in your children's life. End your chapter in your husband's life, in your wife's life, in your career, in your finance. End the chapter of every wicked power fighting your testimony. In Jesus' name we pray.
I pray for everyone. Every wicked power fighting your testimony. From today, I end their chapter in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. By the anointing of God, I release your testimony right now. In Jesus' name, I pray. By faith, just get a testimony seed right now. And for the testimony, I am believing you for by this seed. Bless that seed in your hand right now. Lord, I thank you for what you have done for others. And I thank you for testimonies in the making for me right now. Because this is the week of my testimony. It's the week of my answer. It's the week of my testimony. Move forward right now and drop your testimony seed. God bless you.
There's no one like Jesus. There's no one like him. There's no one like Jesus. There's no one like him. There's no one
like Jesus.
I'm in love.
glory of the Holy Spirit.
It is a sign that your prayer request has been granted. It is a sign that your testimony has been approved spiritually. Somebody shout, I believe.
Shall be seated. God bless you. More Grace Bible College is admitting students into the Bible school. You wish to go to Bible school, it's very important for some. No one is too old, no one is too young for it. Meet the secretary here in church here, get your admission form and fill in the admission form. So, student orientation begins on the 2nd of July, 2nd and 4th of July. New and old students will be getting their orientation. So you can, you have anybody want to go to Bible school? Let the person come to the church, get the form for the secretary. Every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, secretary is in church. Even right now, you can get it there. And remember, it is for all. And God bless you in Jesus' name. Our partners' meeting was a wonderful experience yesterday. We bless God. The teachings you are hearing for the house here, for the altar here, by me, the DVDs are available. Get to the Miracle Arena to get them. All the DVDs, they are available. Get them. Play them time to time. Faith coming by hearing and hearing the word of God. Don't let your mind be dormant. Fill your mind with the word of God. Inside your vehicle, put it there. So the audio CDs will be out. The one you can play inside your bus, inside your vehicle, inside your car. Play them. If you are carrying passengers, maybe you are a bus driver, you carry passenger. Once you start your vehicle full, put the CD, let them be hearing the word of God. You are already preaching. I can see some chairman around. You are already preaching. God bless you. So by the grace of God Almighty, the gospel must go far. This Friday, we have a wonderful service at the prayer mountain. 8 a.m. in the morning. And those that want to go for prayer line, you register 7 a.m. in the morning at the headquarters there. And you have seen what God has been doing to the prayer line. It's a new grace. So this Friday, you'll be there. Don't miss this meeting on Friday. It's a wonderful meeting. We close 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Join us and you will know that God is still very much in the business of responding to his people. All the youth, make sure you are in this program this Friday at the mountain. You need to submit your destiny to God for God to give you the oil for breakthrough. All the men, all the women, be there. God bless you in Jesus' name. A time spent with God is not a waste of time. Family deliverance, if you have not registered, do your registration. Now you have dream purification water. If you have not, you are looking at me. If you have not gotten yours, God has begun to reveal things, more things to me about this. Now, if you have not booked for yours, meet the secretary right now and book for yours. Dream purification water. What God will use this to do for you, mouth cannot explain it. Yes, that's the truth. It is more than what I can explain. Yes, and that is why every one of you, this grace has come to bless you. Just like the message of this morning, the Holy Spirit is in it. It is the Holy Spirit in it that will purify your spirit. This will help you to prepare yourself the more for the Holy Spirit. You will be having night dreams, nightmare. You dream you don't remember, and all sort of nonsense, manipulations. Just take it. Or you have internal sickness. You will be taking drugs. That sickness is not going. Just make this one your drink water. It is not for you to go and just book for one crate. 20 crates. Make it the water you drink in your house. Keep it in your room. Let that be your special water. You will see if the prophetic anointing will not change your life. That simple truth. What the enemy has stolen from you spiritually will be handed over to you. So, you can also tell your friends who are not members of the church, it's a blessing. We are a blessing to the whole world. So, go book a crate. It's just 2,000 naira. It is not for sale. You are only paying for the cellophane, the can, the label, everything.
My name is Prophet P.I.A. Obaseki, the founder of Divine Grace of Glory Church International. Kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, More Grace TV, and turn on the notification button. God bless you. My name is Prophet P.I.A. Obaseki. I'm the founder of Divine Grace of Glory Church International. Connect with me on my Instagram page at P.I.A. Obaseki. Full of prophetic words, healing, deliverance, testimonies. Like, comment, and repost. God bless you. My name is Prophet P.I.A. Obaseki, the founder of Divine Grace of Glory Church International. Kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, More Grace TV, and turn on the notification button. God bless you. My name is Prophet P.I.A. Obaseki, the founder of Divine Grace of Glory Church International. Kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, More Grace TV, and turn on the notification button. God bless you. My name is Prophet P.I.A. Obaseki, the founder of Divine Grace of Glory Church International.
So, not be me to come, now you to come. So it is well with you, but we have to obey the God.
My name is Prophet P.I.A. Obaseki, the founder of Divine Grace of Glory Church International. Kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel.
This Saturday, all amazing sisters, they shall be there. If I were themselves, I will even just book at the headquarters on Friday to sleep there to get more revelation from God. Then on Saturday morning, I just enter the mountain. All amazing sisters, new and old, you are invited this Saturday morning from 7 a.m. And I promise you, I will be on fasting with you from Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, after blessing you before I break my fasting. So I invite you specially to this encounter at the mountain on Saturday morning. I will be there. I tell you, I will be on prayer and fasting from Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, after blessing you before I break my fasting. Thank you. Shall we rest to our feet? Those that want to work in the technical department, yes, I'll be announced. All the sisters, I'm not telling you to go and tempt him. If you try, I will know. I will kick you out. Now, wherever you are, I bless you right now. Wherever you are, I say, I bless you right now. I bless you right now. That stone they thrown to you in the dream, that stone they thrown to you at night, that stone they throw to your roof, that stone they throw to your house, that stone they throw to your business place, that stone they throw to your car, that stone they throw to your vehicle, that stone they throw to your bank account, that stone they throw to your son, that stone they throw to your pregnancy, that stone they throw to your husband, that stone they throw to your wife, that stone they throw to your family, I command that stone to return back to sender in the name of Jesus. Those who are fighting you, they say you have, you don't want to help them. Your children have, only you sit down on their blessing. They say if children get money, it no one help us. May we trouble them, make it die. May we trouble your children, make your children scattered. I stand on this grace today, and I pray for you wherever you are. both in the church and viewers all over the world, wherever you are watching right now, wherever you are hearing me right now, those that gather together to fight your children, to fight you, from today, I command the angel of God to scatter them now. Come here, wherever you are, gathering to fight them. They say, if children get money, they don't buy motor for them. If children don't build house for them. If children, they carry money to give them from abroad. If no one help us, make me use witchcraft, disturb them. Make me use witches and wizards, trouble each children. Make me scatter each children's progress. Make me scatter their family. Make me tie their progress down. Make me tie their business down. Begin it from now. By the anointing that God has given to me, I frustrate their mission against your children. I frustrate their mission against your life. Some other one talk say, now to get children to the talk, make it children get paper for abroad. Now make it see them. We don't sit down. You see what you are doing? We don't sit down for their paper. They now get paper for abroad. We go make them suffer. They go suffer. Anyone that program suffer for your children, from today, they shall suffer. They suffer. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Every form of wickedness, program against your husband, program against your wife, program against your children. I deprogram in the name of Jesus. Hey, they say that to go school, that they talk. If children go school, make them see work now. Make them see work, make them see them. Anyone that use witchcraft to sit down on your children's job, for your children not to see job, today I scatter them by fire. Laremosa to your higher. They say if children they send money, give them. May we give them sickness. Make it they spend the money for sickness. Make it they go from hospital to hospital. You not go get peace. We go seize the peace. Beginning from now, every sickness they have given you, that they gave you in the dream or they gave you in the physical, from now I remove that sickness from your body, back to sender. That sickness back to sender. You are delivered. 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 Not to, they say, not to find the talk. He got fine daughters. He got beautiful sons. Make them marry, make we see them now. We not go ever let them marry. We not go let them marry. We go sit down for their marriage. Anyone that vowed that your children will never be married, today, I key them for your children to be married. I command judgment upon your enemies. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus. They say yes. It's a big work where. It's a big labor where. In money, we now make and see the money for hand. We go to scatter in money. You go to enter into debt, into debt, into debt, into debt. Hey! And then evil court where they carry your matter to. Every evil court where they carry your matter to. To scatter your money. Beginning from now, I command Jesus to appear. To appear in your matter. To appear in your matter. I scatter that court. I release your money for you. I release your money for you. I release your money for you. The other one to say, now we kill your mother. Now we kill your father. Now we kill your husband. We go see kill them too. We not going to let them get peace. We ready for the family. Anyone that boasts that they are ready for your family. They say they are ready for your family. Beginning from now, I command thunder to scatter them now. The God of Pierre, your pastor, is ready for them. I command thunder to scatter them now. Scatter them now. Scatter.
scatter them now. Your family is delivered. Viewers, your family is delivered. Your family is delivered. Your family is delivered. You are blessed right now. In Jesus' name.
Wherever you are, listen. Kabora Zataya. I feel the presence of God. The Holy Ghost put those prayer points in my mouth. I don't know what you are facing. You know any of those prayer points concerns you. It's what you are going through. Just get it. The battle is not your battle. Whatever they agree, they say they will never allow your children to get their paper in abroad. They will never allow your children to marry. They will never allow you to marry. You find, they say you never give your husband. They will never say, if you talk to your husband, they say, not to allow you to get a good job. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. Those who say they are ready for your mother's children, they are ready for your family. God is ready for them now. God is ready for them now. Any area they sit down on top of your blessing, any area they sit down on top of your marriage, any area they sit down on top of your career, on top of your profession, on top of your destiny, they sit down. They say, we will never allow you to have it. It's a lie. It's a lie. After this service, judgment will settle the matter. I say, from this service, judgment will settle the matter. There is going to be judgment and settlement. Father!
They are standing before you, Father. When they are seeing your sacrifice, in my heart, respond to them. Every area the enemy has vowed against them, Father, respond to their enemies. Jehovah, respond to their enemies. They have been killing in your family. They have been killing, 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 killing. Yes, they still vow to continue to kill. Today, the sacrifice you are making in this altar is sending those who are killing, is sending them into their coffin. This is by force. He's sending them back to their coffin. Every other coffin they lined up for the family. They and their family begin to enter the coffin from now. Wherever they took your name to work against you, they work against you, work against your children. To work against your marriage. Come on. Today I stand as a prophet of God. I am frustrated that wickedness in the name of Jesus. Beginning from this very moment, matters are turning for your favor. Matters are turning for your favor. That money they seize from you today in this altar, as you are dropping this seed, you are restoring your money back. As you are dropping this seed, the glory of your finance is coming back to you. I say it is coming back to you. It's coming back to you. In Jesus' name.
Abba Father.
If you are dropping your seat here, drop your seat here. Thank you. Make sure your seat is reasonable. Don't play with God. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Abba Father.
Who is God? Thank you. Thank you. Fast, fast, move fast, please, fast, fast. Time is not on our side. God bless you. The battle is won.
Naturally, Abba Father.
$100 there. You are still putting $100. Roll fast. God bless you. Water in your hand right now. I release the anointing upon that water for divine healing, for restoration. Yes, I can see the angel ministry on the water. Oh, thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The angels are ministering on the water in your hands. Thank you, Holy Father, for the angels. Marie Sola Hisandara Bazatul Pasheka Paribazaturi Mahazanda. Wherever you are having water in your hand, both in the service today or you are watching live, the angels are ministering on that water. It is for signs and wonders. It is for signs and wonders. Yes, thank you, Lord Jesus. As you sprinkle that water in your house, the blood of Jesus Christ surround your house. As you drink that water, it will flush sickness out of your body. The anointing is strong upon that water right now. For your blessing. Yes. Everyone is serviced with a car. Come on. You are going to buzz that water, sprinkle the whole water on your car. Come on, Lubaza. If the one with you now is the one you are going to drink, go and get another one. Hold on. Come. I am going to bless the one in your hand. Bless the one you are going to get after now. The one you are going to get after now, use that. Don't worry, come. Use that one on your car, on your vehicle. The one in your hand now, drink that one on your body. After now, after I'm blessing you, you go and get that one. Just open it. Empty everything on your car. You to sanctify your car. This armed robbery attack that want to snatch a car from you, you will not be a victim of it. Thank you, Father, for blessing the water. This water, bless for your healing. The other one you are about to get, bless to consecrate your vehicle. To consecrate whatever you are using to move. In Jesus' name, I pray. GML. If you didn't meet the message in the first service, wait for second service. Second service is starting right away. God bless you. Go ahead with the man of God's prayer.
This is another dimension in prayer. You killer disease, whatever affliction, whatever virus, hear this announcement. They are not your candidates. Leave my people in the name of Jesus Christ. Leave my people in the name of Jesus Christ. They are not your candidate. Leave my people in the name of Jesus. Leave my people in the name of Jesus. Whatever affliction, leave my people in the name of Jesus Christ. Leave my people in the name of Jesus Christ. Leave their system. Leave their organs in the name of Jesus Christ. They are sick in body. They are in pain. Whatever strange pain in their system, in their
please,
organs,
please, if you are giving pass,
cease in the name of Jesus. Cease in the name of Jesus. Cease in the name of Jesus. I speak your name, Jesus.